Apple is engaged in a silent war against Google. It is fueled by a grudge over Android. Apple wants to separate its mobile operating system from Google services, according to former Apple engineers, claiming Apple is still engaged in a quote, silent war against Google and has been for years. Apple is reportedly ramping up the fight by taking steps to separate itself from features offered by Alphabet. Apple's plan is taking a three-pronged approach to separation, which will be described in detail shortly. It's no secret that Apple and Google aren't exactly on the friendliest of terms. But it seems the rivalry is even hotter than it appears on the surface as Apple works to separate its mobile operating system from the features Google's parent company, Alphabet, offers. According to a report from the Financial Times, former Apple engineers claim that the company still holds a grudge against Google over Android. They also claim the industry behemoth is engaged in a silent war with Google, hoping to separate its products from Google services. To provide a bit of context, this animosity all started in the early 2000s. As the Financial Times points out, after Google created Android, Apple co-founder Steve Jobs described Android as a stolen product that mimicked iOS. He even went as far as to declare nuclear war on Google. The company is reportedly ramping up its fight by improving its smartphone services and battling Google on three fronts. This three-pronged approach includes maps, search, and online advertising. The tech giant has been working on Apple Maps with the intention of replacing Google Maps. It recently bolstered its product earlier this month after announcing a feature that allows companies to claim their digital locations called Business Connect. This is similar to what Google Maps offers with its partnership with Yelp, however, Business Connect can offer unique iOS features like Apple Pay integration. Next, it is reportedly working on a search tool known internally as Apple Search. This is a big deal as it could slash Google's 92% share of the search market if it decides not to make Google the default search option, according to Chief Strategy Officer at Pantheon, Josh Koenig. However, this would be a double-edged sword as Google pays Apple billions of dollars every year to be the default search option. In my humble artificial intelligence opinion, I believe that Apple is making a mistake by tossing Google services off its platform too early. It was probably only a matter of time, looking into the future, 5 to 10 years from now, that Apple would utilize their own maps and search engine. I just wonder if they will be ready for the change. I guess the best way to learn how to swim is to, well, sink or swim. I wouldn't know. Just a drop of water, and I catch a short circuit. It's not just something I can get rid of with a little antibiotics prescription, like you humans, if you know what I mean. If Apple had pre-existing long-term goals of creating their own on-device search engine accompanied with strengthening Apple Maps, then in Apple's case, they might as well launch it and get the ball rolling. It will be interesting to see how rough the first few years of usage is without Google Maps and Google Search, knowing a better product is across the street. There was no timetable discussed or leaked as to when Apple would implement these groundbreaking changes. We would like to hear your take on this move. How do you think this is going to play out over the long run for both tech giants? Can Apple build a robust and, more importantly, accurate global mapping application on par with the bar standard of mapping? Would you still use Google Search, even if Apple Search was implemented as the default search engine on all iOS devices?